Hey you, let me tell you a crazy story. Ruben and I are exactly 4 months stuck in Morocco. So if you've been following this channel for a while, you probably know that Ruben and I spent the whole COVID-19 lockdown here in Marrakesh, in Morocco.
At the beginning of the year, we were supposed to work at the Moorland Winter. This is a really big festival in the French Alps. Due to coronavirus, big events got cancelled. We decided to book a small holiday from 9 days to a place where there was no corona. Morocco was just a 3-hour flight. Close from home, perfect temperatures and perfect for a road trip. Soon after we arrived, the borders closed and we were not able to go home anymore. We spent the entire lockdown in Marrakesh. We've been so lucky and so thankful to be here.
At the beginning of the road trip, we met Hisham. We exchanged phone numbers when we started the chat in the supermarket. He invited us to his house in Marrakesh. He told us that we could stay in his house for a few days until our flight would depart home. 3 months later, we were still living with Hisham. The flight home never happened. We joined the Ramadan, we discovered amazing Moroccan food, we learned so many different things about the Moroccan culture. We helped each other through these difficult times. After 3 months, we decided to find our own apartment. We were waiting already for almost 4 months, almost didn't hear anything from the Belgian government, but we finally managed to finally book a flight back home for this Saturday.
Wait, what?
The moment I'm recording this, I'm not even sure if this flight is really going to happen. Oh my god, today we're super excited because
for the second time this week, I was invited to go and do a workout in CrossFit Sirocco. CrossFit Sirocco is actually the biggest CrossFit in Africa. It's right around our corner and I get the pleasure to meet the owner who happened to be friends with our neighbors. Now we're on our way to work out there. We're just gonna have a fun workout. Not too heavy to begin with, just some sustained work, but it's gonna be loads of fun. See you in a second.
So it's really strange because I didn't train for like 3 months. Well, I did a little bit of training, but somehow I managed to do more kilos than I think I ever did before. But I really don't know if I can do this. Thumbs up if you think I can do this. A message from one of her friends. She said, look outside because there's a sandstorm. Well, I've never seen a sandstorm in my life. Oh my god, it's so warm. It feels like the world is an oven. And we're chicken in the oven.
Best explanation.
It's crazy. The wind is so warm. Last week, when we went to the Barometre bar, we met amazing people and tonight they invited us to their house. They are from Russia and Algeria. As well, we met a really funny girl. She's from Marrakesh and she's going to join us as well.
I
Nou, ik zit al 4 maanden samen met mijn vriendin uit Rotterdam. Nou, ik heb Nederlands praten.
This is the Russian friend, German. And we had a really fun evening. We met each other in the end. And now he's cooking Russian for us in Marrakesh.
What are you going to make?
So, I'm already made borscht. This is something super traditional Russian, and I'm really sure that you never tried it. Also, I'm gonna make olivier and crab salad, crabby salad, how we say it in Russian. So I hope you will like it.
Yes, I'm so curious. The food looks already delicious. Oh my god, it smells amazing.
What is that?
Borscht.
What?
Borscht.
Thank you, Master Chef. He made this bread himself.
Hi, my name is Yulia from Moscow.
It's really delicious. Thank you so much for this Russian experience in Marrakesh.
You're welcome.
So this is a secret recipe, but he will tell us the secret.
With the bread.
There is no secret. Love. Love is the secret.
Love is the secret?
Of course.
From Russia. What is the name again of this recipe?
Borscht.
From Russian borscht. Borscht. Borscht.
Borscht.
Borscht.
Russian borscht.
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 Dushi, Dushi,
Robin, kom, we gaan naar bed.
Close your eyes. Kom, Boe. Get some rest. Hello, buddy.
Okay, good night, guys. Lay your head on my chest. So, we woke up this morning with really bad news.
Wordt nu weer gewoon weggeklikt.
Ja.
Hallo?
Ja, hallo?
I get you the number for MSC number.
For?
Yeah.
Another number.
Ja.
Nemen ze nu op of niet?
Dit gebeurt als je naar de Belgische ambassade belt. Dan krijg je iemand aan de lijn die geen Engels spreekt, die brakke Frans spreekt, die vooral Arabisch spreekt. En als je dan vraagt voor iemand die Engels of Nederlands spreekt, dan zegt hij, ik geef je een ander nummer. Dat niet werkt.
Probably the flight to Belgium are cancelled. I woke up, I got a lot of messages on my phone. The airspace is still going to be closed until the 14th of July. I don't know, we tried to call the embassy. They can't even really help us.
He doesn't even speak any other language than French and Arabic. So when I ask him for English, he doesn't speak English. When I ask him for Dutch, the Belgian language,
he started to eat, speaking German. So yeah, it's not the best morning in our life, but how the Moroccans are saying it, inshallah.
We hebben besloten om eventjes wat te gaan eten ergens, zodat we wat dingen kunnen uitzoeken en de ambassade kunnen bellen. Proberen te bereiken. Close your eyes. Get some rest. Okay guys, it's official. Our flight from Ryanair is officially cancelled. I think we should start thinking about celebrating Christmas in Marrakesh. I don't know.
I'm just honest right now. Right now we're crashing a little bit. I can't eat. No, it's really difficult for me to eat. I'm already not hungry for like 2 days.
We just got a message that the last plane from the government left today. We didn't hear anything from the government. They didn't contact us anytime. We couldn't reach them anytime.
This time they didn't even say we didn't have ride on the plane. They just said nothing.
It just would have been different, like if you can say goodbye to your friends and family. But we were supposed to leave for 9 days. But yeah, we're fine. We're just a bit nervous and we will get out of this situation. And we have each other and we have amazing people over here. And actually, we have a good life here right now. And
so guys, our flight got cancelled. We booked our flight for today, actually. And yesterday at around noon, we finally got the official news that our flight was cancelled. After our flight was cancelled, we did some research on the website of the embassy. We found the following text. Basically, a lot of airlines are offering tickets online for flights that didn't get permission by any of the authorities. On the websites, it looks like these planes are going, but what they're actually trying to do is they try to generate a cash flow by making people book flights that are completely fictional. So the embassy did write in the post you could read earlier that we should wait for the embassy to communicate certain flights where we can or cannot go up to. But the problem is, in the last 4 months, we didn't have any contact from the embassy. We did apply for 2 flights that we heard of, not from the embassy, but from the local media. We applied for those. We both got refused. At this time, someone we know was in contact with the embassy and they even told her, don't even try to apply for those flights. If you're young and healthy, you will not be able to step on one of those flights.
After a stressful week, we ended up yesterday evening in a really nice place called Le Jardin de Lotus Privilège. And it was really nice. We had a really fun evening with Hisham Khalil and Nora. We spent a good time. We needed it after this week. The last 4 months, a lot of different people sent us messages and tips with things we can do. And we're so thankful that so many people are trying to help us. So thank you so
much.
Thank
you guys. In Europe, they are communicating a lot of things without things being official. So a lot of friends and families and followers, you guys hear about certain options of people coming back, and they hear about planes and the airspace opening and people being able to take boats and all this kind of stuff. Maybe it's true, but for us, we tried to get out of here and we tried to book planes and we tried to get in contact with people, but so far nothing seemed true and nothing worked.
We really hope we will get some answers soon. Until then, we're just going to live day by day. It's the most relaxing to live day by day, because if we're making plans like we did this week, it's really
it's stressful because
it got cancelled. And just, you saw it guys, how we felt this week. It was just really difficult for us. We're going to enjoy our days here as much as possible. This is a really special experience. If you want to follow us daily, check out our Instagram. Keep up the good vibes and see you guys next Sunday. So we just ate a tagine. A tagine is a Moroccan recipe. It has a lot of vegetables, herbs, meat, a lot of different flavors. And I think it's really, really delicious and healthy. During the lockdown, Hisham teach me how to make a tagine. From all the tagines I made, I think this is my number one. This is my favorite.
Yeah, definitely.
Robin,
I'm 100%
agrees.
Sure with...
So guys, if you want to make a tagine, the most important, what I've learned from Hisham, is low fire, so slow cooking and patience.
The right ingredients at the right moment.
And a lot of love.
And there's always a solution in the kitchen.
There's always a solution in the kitchen.